Disclaimer, I'm not a lawyer, but I love reading law books. I'm Professor Alan Noguera, a part-time college professor, a toastmaster, a business owner, and a leadership coach. My friends around the globe, today I will share to you one of my readings from Labor Code of the Philippines. So I will speak English and Tagalog. So ready na tayo to know our law. So remember, Article 3 of Civil Code, ignorance of the law excuses no one. So let's apply and mindful to that law. So mga kababayan ko, so let's know our law and be a law-abiding citizen. So my topic today is Article 294. So allow me to read this article and let's explain concisely and simply. So what is Article 294? Security of tenure. In cases of regular employment, the employer shall not terminate the services of an employee except for a just cause or when authorized by this title. So mga empleyado, mga kababayan ko, so pag regular employee tayo, meron tayong what we call security of tenure. Ibig sabihin, hindi tayo basta-basta i-terminate ng employer natin for two reasons only na ma-terminate tayo sa service or matanggal tayo sa serbisyo. Number one is just causes and number two, authorized causes. Mamaya i-enumerate ko ano tong mga just causes and authorized causes. So our second question is, what happen if matanggal tayo sa trabaho? Anong mangyari sa employer? So let's continue reading Article 294. All an employee who is unjustly dismissed from work shall be entitled to reinstatement without loss of seniority rights and other privileges and to his full back wages, inclusive of allowances and to his other benefits or their monetary equivalent computed from the time his compensation was withheld from him up to the time of his actual reinstatement. So ang employer, my friend, makompel na ibalik yung regular employee na giterminate niya. And this time with back wages. And of course, hindi yung seniority rights niya. Hindi affected. So, ma-retain yung position niya actually. And possibly ma-promote pa. So, yan yung ano natin sa Article 294. So, security of tenure. So, to all regular employees, whether private company kayo or government offices, do not worry. Meron tayong law that will give you protection na hindi kayo tanggalin ng employer. Ang tawag niyan, security of tenure. So, this time, let's talk about just causes and authorized causes. Ano ba ang mga examples nito? Actually, ang just causes ng termination ng employee is nasa Article 297. So let me read Article 297. Termination by employer. An employer may terminate an employment for any of the following causes. So ito na. Enumerate ko na. Number one, serious misconduct or willful disobedience by the employee of the lawful orders of his employer or representative in connection with his work. Number two, gross and habitual neglect by the employee of his duties. Number three, fraud or willful breach by the employee of the trust reposed in him by his employer or duly authorized representative. Number four, commission of a crime or offense by the employee against the person of his employer or any immediate member of his family or his duly authorized representative. And number five, other causes analogous to the foregoing. So yan yung just causes. So serious misconduct. So for example, dishonesty. Gross and habitual neglect by the employee of his duties. Example, habitual absences, habitual tardiness. That is ground for termination. Yung pala absent and pala late na habitual na. So, hindi na pwede yan itolerate na employer even though you are a regular employee. Fraud. Yung mga illegal activities. So, of course, lalo na pag involve yung money. So, pwede ka tanggalin dyan. Commission of a crime. Yan, of course. Yung murder. Of course. Grounds for termination. And other causes analogous to the foregoing. So, moving forward to our authorized causes. So, nandito yan sa Article 298. The employer may also terminate the employment of any employee due to the installation of labor savings devices, redundancy, retrenchment to prevent losses, or the closing or cessation of operation of the establishment. So yan yung authorized causes, tatlo. Labor, installation of labor saving devices. Yung mga, mayroon natin yung mga technology, modern technology. So, lesser manpower na yan. So, pwede natanggalin yung mga employee. And number two, redundancy. Yung pare-pareho nila na ng trabaho. So, ang employer has the right to terminate yung pare-pareho na ng trabaho ang employee. Redundancy. And of course, pag may losses na yung company, so mag-retrench na yan sila to prevent losses from their end. So friends, now you know the Article 294 of Labor Code and also the Article 297 and Article 298. So, thank you for watching this video. Hope you like it. And please share this video to your friends, office mates, and relatives who are employees. And appreciate much if you will subscribe at my YouTube channel. Simply click the subscribe button below. I have helpful videos for you in my succeeding videos. I will talk about labor code, civil code, and other motivational videos. Right? So, bye for now and two thumbs up.